Good afternoon, and welcome to the Liston B. Ramsey Center on the campus of Western Carolina University. 16 months have passed since the last in-person commencement ceremony at WCU, and we are so excited to finally celebrate our graduates on campus. I'm Josh Thompson. I have the pleasure of serving as the Director of Undergraduate Orientation. Thank you so much for joining us for our pre-show coverage of our undergraduate commencement ceremony for the College of Health and Human Sciences. There is no denying that this class of students has experienced college in the most unique way possible. From a solar eclipse to a once-in-a-century pandemic, the class of 2021 has seen it all.
And our newest family members, the WCU class of 2020.
The sun right now. I am seeing the corona of the sun.
We are 10 seconds away.
I invite all the speakers and the Brown family to join me at the podium to formally reopen Brown Hall.
Hello, I'm Allison Morrison Chandler, interim chancellor here at Western Carolina University. We're inspired by you coming here. Wear your purple. Proudly be Academite.
Without a new natural sciences building, our growth in these important disciplines will slow to a trickle.
Like, I really want this NFL dream to come true. I don't even know, what word can I say? What word can I say?
He took the office of chancellor and he made it into something so much bigger.
Beginning in the fall of 2018, the state of North Carolina will dramatically reduce tuition at three of our public universities.
I can't wait to immerse myself in the total Western Carolina University experience and to meeting more members of my Catamount family.
Not every day that someone gets a dormitory named for them just because she needed 9 hours.
We just did that. We just did that.
We had to do it though.
Yep. We had to do it.
Opportunity of a lifetime. I'll never forget it.
Together we can build a consistently highly competitive program here across the board at Western Carolina.
That's why we have moved away from face-to-face classes to online learning and other alternative methods whenever possible for the remainder of the spring semester.
Although neither of them attended WCU, they've certainly earned the right to be honorary Catamounts.
He gives is out of his heart. Bill is a model for many of us to follow.
Western Carolina University has a brand new vaccination clinic open to assist with delivering it to people in the region.
Every student will walk across the stage, pick up their diploma, have a picture with the chancellor, and have their name announced.
As you just saw, a lot has happened since these graduates started their journey here at WCU 4 years ago, or maybe 5 or 6 years ago. And it has taken some serious perseverance. We are so excited to celebrate them today, and we have the perfect guests to get us started. When Chancellor Kelly Brown started her journey at WCU, she probably didn't think that her first spring commencement wouldn't happen until almost 2 years into her tenure. But the day is finally here, and we are so excited to have Chancellor Brown with us this morning. We're also very excited to have a surprise special guest from the Board of Governors, Mr. Phil Byers. Welcome, Mr. Byers and Chancellor Brown. Chancellor Brown, we are now on ceremony 6 of 6. How does it feel to be almost done with your first spring commencement?
It feels fantastic. It is so great to have so many students be able to walk across the stage, pick up their diploma, have their families and friends and guests here cheering them on. I can see the smiles on their faces, even behind the mask.
Mr. Byers, you've mentioned in your speeches earlier how important WCU has been to the vaccine distribution here within the UNC system. Can you elaborate on that for us?
I certainly will. Not only for the university, but the COVID vaccinations for the entire Jackson County and the mountains of Western North Carolina. Of all 17 institutions, Western Carolina was number one in the number of vaccinations. And that's an impact not only for this university, but as well for entire Western North Carolina. It's critical.
Chancellor Brown, as our students prepare to walk across the stage today, they may be walking away from Cullowhee, but they're not walking away from Western Carolina University. What kind of advice do you have for our newest alumni to stay in touch with the university?
Absolutely. Well, they will always be at Catamount, and they were always welcome back to Western Carolina University. They will take with them the pride and the passion of being at Catamount into their workplace, if they're going off to graduate school, and they're always welcome back here in Cullowhee.
Mr. Byers, as we get ready to start a new fall, what is the Board of Governors excited for moving forward?
Football season. No, is we're ready for normalcy. I don't know that that's a word that's even in our vocabulary anymore, but we certainly are ready for enrollment increases and for our chancellors and for our students to enjoy what college life is about. I feel a little sorry for, and I mean this in the best ways, for our students graduating today because their senior year was not quite what it should have been, what we have grown accustomed to, but they survived, they worked hard. And the positive part is I don't think they're going to run into anything in the business world that they can't handle after dealing with their senior year.
Hey, Phil, you've mentioned that WCU is special. What to you makes this place special?
Well, I actually graduated from this wonderful institution, 1999, with a master's degree in public affairs and met my mentor, Don Livingston, who was part of the department then. He's retired now, living down in Savannah, and I'm sure he's working real hard at the beach or at the waterfront, but I love Cullowhee, love coming home. I spent my entire college time in the mountains. I won't mention the other university I spent 8 years at, but in Boone, North Carolina, but this is, it's home. It's a lot of good things happen here, and if the mountains of North Carolina, if we're going to continue this economic drive, it has to be based around Western Carolina University.
Thank you, Mr. Byers. Chancellor Brown, final thoughts from you. What are you excited for the fall?
I'm excited for the fall to have, as Governor Byers said, football, Valley Ballyhoo, the grand student experience that we have here, students engaging with faculty in and outside of the classroom, students volunteering all across Western North Carolina. It's going to be a great fall to be here in Cullowhee, North Carolina.
Well, I know that you two have some work to do before you head up on stage, so we'll let you go. We appreciate you joining us here today to talk to our viewers at home and here in the Ramsey Center. It's obvious that the students have had to have some serious grit over the last 4 years, but they haven't done it alone. Countless professors, staff, and family members have been by their side over the last 4 years, and they certainly couldn't have done it without them. We asked a few of our students to write a letter to someone who had a significant impact on their time at WCU. Here's what they had to say.
I'm about to email you something right quick.
Okay.
And I want you to read it.
Would you like me to read it out loud?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay. All right. I'm ready, Mike, and I'm good to go. Debbie, I would like to express my gratitude for being one of your students.
Dear Dr. Tiggins Wiggin Davis, thank you. You have given me so much over these past 4 years, whether that be a shoulder to cry on, a listening ear, or even a punch to the gut in the form of a hard lesson you were trying to give me.
I know that teachers like you are not easy to find. Each day you came to class with a smile on your face and kind, encouraging words for each student.
As a mentor, you have helped me to reach new heights in both my academic career
and in my community service endeavors, to help in bettering everyone around me and help communities that I serve.
أنا ممتن لوجودكم في حياتي ودعمكم اللامتناهي وإذن الاستماع كلما تقطعت السبل عني أو احتجت إلى المساعدة أو أردت شخصا قريبا للتحدث معه.
Again, thank you. Just doesn't seem like enough, but thank you for making my time at Western easier, and thank you for being one of the reasons why it would be so hard to say goodbye to my undergraduate life.
Lauren, that is so sweet. You're going to make me cry.
Thank you very much, and congratulations for you, bro.
Thank you more, because my air college, I was just quiet, never talked. And there are people like you who helped me open up and get my heart out to whatever I was doing and to continuously better myself.
James, I appreciate that. It's been such a gift to watch you walk this journey and to watch you develop as the young man who is going to go out and make some dynamic changes in the world.
It just doesn't feel like enough. It really doesn't. I truly, truly appreciate you for everything. Even at times where I was ready to quit and give up, you just kept reminding me that I was here for a purpose, that God always has a plan for me, and I can't imagine what it would have been like without you and your presence in my life. So again, thank you, Dr. Takis.
Hey there. I can't even believe that here we are, ready for commencement already. Grads, we are so proud of all that you've accomplished during this crazy, unpredictable year. You have demonstrated grit and resiliency. You have persevered against obstacles and overcome challenges. And you have looked ahead to step forward and make a difference in helping our entire community pull together and serve those in need. Today at commencement, it is time that we celebrate you and take this time to acknowledge all you've worked for and the goals that you've achieved. I am so proud of you and truly honored to welcome you to your new role as Western alumni. While it may be cliche to say that commencement is the start of a new journey, it's also true. And I hope that you take with you the confidence and experience that you've earned here at WCU. To the families of our grads, I just want to say thank you for sharing these great students, great people with us. I join you in being so proud of their accomplishments and equally their character. These grads have done so much to serve their communities and to lift up their fellow Catamounts. I'm grateful every day for these students and impressed with how graciously they've navigated the challenges of this year. Grads, congratulations again on behalf of the Brinson Honors College. Wherever you are today, know that you are in our hearts and minds. We are celebrating with you this important achievement. Do please keep in touch. You made a mark on this university, and I'm sure you will continue to do so. This is just the beginning of your journey as new WCU alumni. Go Cats.
Congratulations, graduates from the College of Health and Human Sciences. Wow, what a year. Life definitely threw us all a curveball with a pandemic. Through it all, you persevered and rose to the challenge to overcome obstacles and trials that you encountered. Resiliency was the key. Resilience allowed you to cope and gave you the courage, strength, and wisdom to carry on. Your educational pursuit has provided you a solid foundation to launch from. None of us know what the future will hold. You are on your A game right now, and my greatest desire for you is that you will have a growth mindset and the determination to achieve the dreams and goals that you have. As you continue on your life's journey, you will have disappointments. At those times, you will draw from your inner strength and move ahead. This makes me think of Captain Sully Sullenberger and how he reacted with the split-second decision that he made in 2009 that saved everyone who was on the U.S. Airways Flight 1549. As he reflected on his experience, his takeaway was, "I was sure I could do it." I think in many ways, as it turned out, my entire life up to that moment had been a preparation to handle that particular moment. I greatly admire his reflection and wisdom that he drew upon.
You never know what you will encounter in the future. Remember, you will always have your experience and preparation from Western Carolina University to draw upon. I like to say you are grit. You are a graduate who is resilient with an inherent tenacity. Congratulations. I know you will make everyone proud as you embark on the future ahead of you.
There's no doubt it takes some serious dedication to earn your college degree. For some, though, an undergraduate degree is just the beginning. Tracy Hewitt graduated Friday night with a master's in education with a focus on STEM. We got to go inside Tracy's classroom to see how she's using her experience at WCU to enhance how her students learn, all while making it a whole lot of fun. We then got the chance to catch up with Tracy at the graduation ceremony on Friday night, so we'll take a look at that right after this video.
It really is an amazing feeling to know that I am, what I'm doing in outside of school is impacting my students at school. So my name is Tracy Hewitt. I am a third grade teacher at IC Imagine, which is a charter school in Asheville, North Carolina. And I am a graduate student at Western Carolina University, receiving a Master's of Arts in Education with a focus on STEM and elementary education. So I'm lucky in the fact that I've always known I wanted to be a teacher since I was a little kid, but as I got older and started going to high school and college, I realized that it's just the perfect profession for me. I decided to go back to school just to better myself as a teacher. I had been teaching for about 3.5 years at that point, and I was growing a lot in the classroom, but I knew that there could be another layer to it. And then I found the STEM program at Western Carolina University, and I felt that it was a great program for me because actually before I started this program, I didn't consider myself a math or science person. Like, STEM wasn't a huge focus. So I kind of saw it as a gap in my teaching skills, and I decided to start the program in order to fill in that gap. But really, it's been amazing, the transformation I've made as a teacher. I went from someone who was like, yeah, I'll try doing like a hands-on activity every now and again, to someone who's like, okay, what's the next one we're gonna do? Like, next week we're gonna start doing landform dioramas now, and you know, it just goes on, and it's been really amazing. Some important aspects of STEM are that the activities are hands-on, and they relate to the student's real world. So, for example, today we're building Mars rovers in class, and we're using a measurement standard to make those rovers the right size. And I could just have students like use a ruler and measure random things on their desk, or I could have them measure on a worksheet. But by building the rovers and actually seeing, okay, if I don't measure it correctly, I'm not going to be able to fit the wheel and axles on, and it won't move. And that is really helping them see why measuring accurately is important, and not just how to do it, but the why behind it. And they're really able to gain those skills that they need. The difference is just so apparent in how I'm able to implement STEM activities, and then it goes beyond that too. I've taken classes on assessment, diversity, leadership, so it really has a ripple effect in my whole career, and it's really been incredible. It really can be hard to get started with STEM. You need materials, you need a framework, but this program has really provided that support for me, and now I feel after I graduate, I'm just gonna be able to keep doing that because I have the momentum going, and because I know how easy and fun it is for myself as a teacher and especially for my students.
And we are here with Tracy now. So Tracy, as a teacher, I have to know, what was it like teaching during the COVID-19 pandemic?
It was definitely a whirlwind, a lot of adjustments and things thrown at us that we didn't expect. I taught virtually for about 8 months, and then under a hybrid model, and then finally back in person with my students. I've been amazed at how resilient the students have been and how much they've been able to adjust to this hard time.
And today was the first day you've been on campus as you end your program. What was it like to come to campus for the first time?
It's been wonderful. It's an absolutely beautiful campus. People are friendly, and it's really great to be here.
Final question, what would you say to all of the aspiring teachers who are graduating today?
I would say you have a journey ahead of you, but it is a really rewarding, fun, and hard journey. So good luck.
It's obvious that teachers and students have been greatly We thank Kelly so much for her time and wish her the best of luck in her future. And we thank all of you for joining us today as we celebrate our 2021 spring graduates. We have waited so long for this day, and we couldn't be more excited for what's to come. We know so many of you couldn't be here today, but we know that you're here in spirit. Be sure to check out all of our amazing graduate features over at commencement.wcu.edu. Enjoy today's ceremony, and as always, go Cats!
Chancellor Brown, the graduating students have now assembled for the 2021 undergraduate spring commencement exercises for the College of Health and Human Sciences.
Please remain standing as we each pause for a moment of silent reflection on the special meaning of this day. Thank you. Please join in singing the national anthem led by Helena Shropshire, a junior in the music education program in the School of Music.
Who say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
Thank you, Helena. You may be seated. Graduates and distinguished guests, it is a pleasure and honor to welcome each of you to the 2021 undergraduate spring commencement ceremony for the students in the College of Health and Human Sciences at Western Carolina University. Before we begin today's ceremony, you may notice some changes at odds with our signage on campus. In light of Governor Cooper's announcement yesterday afternoon, we are glad to accommodate and welcome our general admission guest. We also ask that our graduates to keep their masks on during the ceremony, and we ask that our audience to maintain physical distancing wherever possible from those not in their party. Please allow me to recognize members of the platform party who do not have speaking roles in the commencement program. I ask them to stand and remain standing as I call their names. Please hold your applause until I've introduced them all. First, members of the Western Carolina University's Board of Trustees, Mr. Bob Roberts, Vice Chair, Mrs. Rebecca Schlosser, Secretary, and Mrs. Kathy Greeley. Next, our WCU administrative staff, Dr. Sam Miller, Vice Chancellor for Student Affairs, Mr. Mike Byers, Vice Chancellor for Administration and Finance, Mrs. Jamie Rayner, Interim Vice Chancellor for Advancement. Representing all faculty is Dr. Cadence Otto, Faculty Senate Chair. Representing all students is Mr. Dawson Spencer, past President of the Student Government Association. And representing all staff is Mr. Ben Pendry, Staff Senate Chair. Please join me in recognizing these institutional leaders. Mr. Brian Kinney, Chair of the WCU Board of Trustees, will now bring greetings from the board.
Thank you, Chancellor Brown. And thank you, graduates, your families, to our alumni, to the university's leadership, the university's distinguished faculty and staff, my fellow trustees, and members of the platform party. It gives me great pleasure to bring greetings, congratulations, and well wishes from all the members of the Western Carolina University Board of Trustees. Graduates, congratulations. Even in a year like this, you made it. That's great. We're proud of you. During these past few years in Cullowhee, I know you've developed lifelong friendships and memories. And over the past year, even some of those may have been made on Zoom or WebEx or other virtual means. You have persevered. You've overcome obstacles. You've done so this past year in ways that I couldn't have imagined when I was going through my senior year here in Cullowhee and walking across this stage a few decades ago. By the way, with a degree from back then the School of Nursing and Health Sciences, with a bachelor's in emergency medical care, so you are my kindred spirits. In doing so, you all receive not only a great education that has helped prepare you for what life will bring your way, but you developed a sense of determination that will increase your will to succeed. Now, you get to go out and truly show the world what you can do. You're our future, the future of this wonderful mountain region we all love, the great state of North Carolina, our nation, and our world. So, no pressure. But we're really dependent on you. I am confident, though, of any class, you'll not let us down. You've proven over these past, well, more than 12 months now, that you can manage anything, including a pandemic. If you ever wondered what a Board of Trustees does, I want to tell you that one of the best parts of this job is bragging. Just like your parents, grandparents, spouses, siblings, and friends that are around you here today are joining us virtually, we brag about you a lot. We brag about your successes in the classroom, in undergraduate research, in community service, about your being players of the week for various Southern Conference sports, about your artwork, and about your performances. Your achievements reinforce our pride in Western Carolina University. Thank you for all you do. More importantly, though, thank you for all you will do to continue to make us proud, because we all are very proud of you. Congratulations and thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kenning. We certainly appreciate your participation in our ceremony and bringing greetings from the Board of Trustees. Mr. Philip Byers, member of the University of North Carolina Board of Governors, will now bring greetings from the Board and from the Office of the President.
It is somewhat ironic that in 10 days I have had the opportunity and the pleasure of speaking to 20 commencement ceremonies at four different universities. It took me 8 years at Appalachian State to walk across the stage the first time with my bachelor's degree. I was on that extended plan. I didn't want to leave, and so when they made me leave Boone, I came to Cullowhee, where I stayed for 5 years and left with a Master of Public Administration. So I am one of you, we have that in common, and that would have been in 1999. My friend from the Board of Trustees graduated in 1969. There's a little difference there. 1999 should mean something to you, because I'm thinking that's when most of you were born. Show of hands, everybody born in 99. Yeah, thanks. It is indeed my honor to be with you, and I do, now that I've got the chancellor nervous. See, I can come on campus and do stuff, and I make everybody nervous, and they just want me to hurry and get off campus. So now that I've got her nervous, I'll go ahead with my prepared text. Greetings from the Board of Governors. Good afternoon, and it is absolutely a pleasure to bring to you greetings from the UNC system and our president. You graduates and your families and friends, WCU alumni, Chancellor Kelly Brown, and the Board of Trustees, the university's faculty and staff, and members of this platform committee. It's an honor and a pleasure for me to bring a message of greetings and congratulations from UNC President Peter Hans and the staff of the UNC System Office, UNC Board of Governors Chair Randy Ramsey, and all my fellow members of the UNC Board of Governors. To you graduates, it's a delight to look around and see the joy in your eyes and your family members and friends, and to share your excitement with you. Collectively, we acknowledge the long hours of hard work it took for you to get to this point. We honor you today for the commitment you have demonstrated to better your life by obtaining your degree. In doing so, you not only have done something important for yourself and your families, but you have accomplished something that improves the communities and our entire world. As individuals, each of you has much to celebrate, but Western Carolina University is reaching great milestones as well, and I want to just mention a few of those. First, I would be remiss if I did not mention the dynamic leadership provided by our Chancellor, Chancellor Kelly Brown, who is getting to experience the spring graduation for the first time as the pandemic prevented us from this ceremony last year. I would ask that you join me in a show of appreciation to our Chancellor for the hard work and dedication that she has given over the past year and a half to make sure you had the opportunity to be here today. I realize Chancellor Brown has been very impressed with the faculty and staff at Western Carolina University and their dedication to student academics and overall student experience here at Western Carolina. One great example of that work is a $600,000 grant from the U.S. Department of Education to help improve academic skills of students at Cullowhee Valley School who speak English as another language. Also, how could I not mention your faculty, staff, and students quickly setting up COVID-19 vaccination clinic, rapidly completing the backlog for Jackson County, and expanding to provide this vital resource to entire Western North Carolina region. This is a historic feat for Western Carolina University and a job well done. I would ask that we show our appreciation to you, those of you who helped and volunteered, and to our faculty and staff, and to our chancellor for that tremendous job in improving the quality of life by providing that vaccine for so many in Western North Carolina. And I won't forget to mention what a hot commodity Western Carolina University is, as this institution has once again set an enrollment record for the past fall. A variety of factors are playing into our increased enrollment, including the great work of our faculty and staff, as I mentioned before, and Western Carolina University status in the UNC System's North Carolina Promise program, which lowers the cost of tuition and makes attending the university affordable for students and their families. Great things are happening in Cullowhee and across the state of North Carolina. Collectively, our 17 UNC campuses comprise a public university system that is second to none in this country. You graduates will receive the benefit of that reputation as you go into the workforce or continue your education.
As you go about your daily lives, I encourage you to take the time to savor memories that you experience from Western Carolina University. Stay connected to this wonderful school and its people. Come back often as you land that first job, and I know many of you have done so. Always remember Western Carolina University, because those of us who came before you remember Western Carolina University with our contributions, whether that's hundreds of thousands or $25 a year, matters not. What matters is you contribute back to this great university so we can continue to increase enrollment and provide the quality of education that you received for generations of students to come. I thank you, I congratulate you, go Cats.
Thank you, Mr. Byers. We certainly appreciate your participation in our ceremony and your words of congratulations to our students. You are a true friend of the institution and a great supporter. Thank you very much. It is now my pleasure to recognize Provost Richard Starnes, who will introduce the commencement speaker.
Each year, a graduating WCU student is selected to deliver remarks to our graduating class and guests. We invite submissions from all of our graduating students, and a committee of faculty and staff from across campus review those submissions. Without fail, the committee receives entries from remarkable students and are faced with the difficult task of selecting a speaker. I would like to thank the Commencement Speaker Committee of 2021 for their hard work in choosing a dynamic, energetic, and dedicated student speaker for this year's undergraduate commencement ceremony. The student selected is graduating from the College of Health and Human Sciences with a Bachelor's of Science degree in Integrated Health Sciences. This student already has a tremendous list of accomplishments of which to be proud. She graduated from A.L. Brown High School in 2017. Outside of class, she has served as a mentor and as a member of the executive board of Project CARE, as well as the chief of Intercultural Affairs Council. She provided community service at the poverty simulation, as well as at an animal shelter in Kannapolis. The Western Carolina community is proud to congratulate this student on her achievements, and all those we know await her in her future. Graduating Catamounts, faculty, staff, and esteemed family and friends, please join me in welcoming Ms. Courtney Z. Harris to the podium. Before I yield the microphone to Ms. Harris, I would like to recognize her with a plaque on behalf of WCU commemorating her selection as the 2021 undergraduate spring commencement speaker.
Good afternoon, fellow Catamounts. Before I begin, I would like to extend a huge congratulations to all the graduates here. I would also like to say thank you to family and friends who are here to support us on this lovely occasion. A special thank you to faculty and staff and administration for helping to make this day possible. Today, we are here to celebrate reaching a goal that took hard work, dedication, compassion, and integrity to obtain. Everyone in this room should feel immensely proud of themselves, and for that, please give yourselves a round of applause. For those of you who do not know me, I am Courtney Harris. I am the daughter of Serena Rush and Curtis Harris. My parents are sitting over there. I am an integrated health science major with a concentration in healthcare administration. I am someone who strives for greatness and searches for opportunity for growth. Attending Western Carolina has not only allowed me to continue my pursuit for greatness, but also offered me opportunities to which my growth was challenged. Western Carolina is an institution that teaches individual life lessons, the meaning of love, the definition of what it means to be dedicated, political awareness, and even how to hike. Western has offered different experiences for all of us, but I believe I can speak for everyone when stating the Catamount experience is an eccentric one. This school provides the experience you need to develop and evolve into the individual ready to take this world by storm. Being at this institution, I experienced guidance from faculty and staff, community from my peers, recognition and support from administration, and most importantly, I felt seen and cared for. This college journey is similar to a child's developmental milestones. Stick with me here. As we all know, children go through developmental milestones in the way they play, learn, act, and move. Milestones such as uttering their first word and going to daycare for the first time. Some of us were happy to go and experience this new place, but some of us, we were hesitant, and some, we were even scared. During this journey, we learned many things. In daycare, you meet other little people and try things for the first time, similar to the journey of freshman year. During freshman year, we are exposed to others with common interests, experience cultural differences, and we're exposed to campus living. We begin to see that the world offers more than what we thought. As we all know, freshman year is like no other. This year came with many firsts. We remember Valley Ballyhoo and being introduced to all Western had to offer. The football games and chanting, "Western, Western, go Western." Hanging out with friends in our residence halls and participating in service events like Dance Marathon, where we raise money for the Children's Hospital. This year also offered a variety of lessons. Some of us, we were told that this year was very important in our development. This did not mean that the other years to come was not as important, but this year held great value. We set the foundation for the next 3 years. We were placed into a different environment and we were challenged to learn and adapt. This year encompassed meeting new people, stepping outside of our comfort zone, creating bonds, and looking for community engagement opportunities, and also figuring out good study habits. Now, we have all gotten familiar with the routine of daycare. We began to get comfortable. While still learning and discovering the many toys and new books that we love, a lot like sophomore year. This year in particular wasn't hard, but it wasn't quite so easy either. During this time, we were now familiar with the university and other members of the community. We were still picking up new skills and knowledge along the way. We were no longer new to the environment, but we began to feel comfortable. Sophomore year is a time where we branched out more than we once did, enjoyed other things that the campus offered, such as attending carnivals, theater showcases, attending track meets and baseball games, even exploring the nearby communities. We began to join clubs and organizations along with transitioning out of freshman housing. Some of us may have even transitioned some of our friend groups. In other words, this year was theoretically comfortable, yet captivating. Now that we've had time to settle into our daycare, we began to define ourselves and test the skills we've learned so far. We are still exploring our opportunities. In similarity, junior year brings the same experience. It brings many new challenges and explorations. For a lot of us, these challenges were brought on by the transition out of liberal studies courses into our courses tailored for our major, and even internships. For some, this was the moment you realize you may have chosen the wrong major. For others, you begin to enjoy the things your major has to offer. During this time, we started to finally feel like adults. Many of us have moved out of on-campus housing and into our very own apartments, which brings a new experience in and of itself. This year taught us balance, maturity, and responsibility. This was the year we recognized we were almost there. Now we have finally reached the moment in daycare where we can dress ourselves, and we know what we like and what we don't like. We are seasoned, and no longer are we in a space where we cry getting out of the car. Daycare is now exciting. We have a core group of friends who can't wait to see us and play with us. It is now senior year. Now we have come into ourselves. We now understand better than we once did. We are and what we will become. We have decided what makes us happy and what areas we still need to work on. We finally realize we are about to exit one journey and begin another. We made it. Although we are closing one chapter, we are able to look back and see the beauty Western has offered us. We begin to cherish the last few days of our college career. We have come so far, and we all have accomplished so much. I share in the same level of excitement and tremble with the same nervousness as each one of you. I stand before you, confident in knowing we are prepared for whatever comes our way. Through this journey, we all faced many challenges. These challenges have shaped and influenced our paths. Some of us, we didn't know how we were going to pay for college. For some, we were undeclared for a semester, or two, or even three. But we figured it out. Some of us failed a class, may have had to take a W, but we figured it out. Some of us struggle with depression, but we figured it out. And all of us face our most recent challenge, COVID-19. This pandemic has impacted us all and has disrupted our normal routine. It has impacted billions around the world, but we are figuring it out. I want us to look at this next step as another opportunity for growth and development. We will overcome this challenge just like we have before. We will figure it out. As my speech comes to an end, I would like to leave you all with this. Don't be afraid to build on your experiences you had here. Create new ones. Celebrate success, but accept failures. Have faith in the energy that you put forth. Let's use the many lessons we've learned during our time here at Western to impact the world for better. Let's show the world what Catamounts are made of. Wherever this next journey may take you, I wish you all much success, much happiness, and a blessed journey. And lastly, go Cats.
Thank you, Ms. Harris, for your thoughtful remarks over your 4 years here. It's always a joy to hear our student speakers. Again, thank you, Courtney, so much. At this time, Provost Richard Starnes will recognize the university scholars and begin today's presentation of candidates for degrees.
Chancellor Brown, it is my pleasure to recognize those students who enrolled as freshmen at Western Carolina University and who have completed their entire undergraduate careers with a perfect record, a 4.0 grade point average. Having consistently met the rigorous standards of our faculty, they deserve the special recognition as university scholars. I ask the following individuals to stand and be recognized during this spring commencement, and please hold your applause until all have been introduced. Maddox Bulris, Jessica Duckwall, Jessica Gibson, Connor Henderson, Alexis Mosier. Please congratulate these students on this outstanding achievement. Chancellor Brown, I now call upon the deans of the colleges to present to you the candidates for degrees. Dr. Jill Granger, Dean of the Brinson Honors College.
I ask all candidates for degrees who are members of the Brinson Honors College to please stand and remain standing. Chancellor Brown, the Brinson Honors College is pleased and proud to present candidates who will graduate with full honors. Candidates who are graduating with full honors are distinguished by the Honors Medallion.
Dr. Lori Anderson, Dean of the College of Health and Human Sciences.
I ask all candidates for the degrees from the College of Health and Human Sciences to please stand and remain standing. Chancellor Brown, the College of Health and Human Sciences is pleased to present the candidates for the Bachelor of Science degree, the Bachelor of Science degree in Nursing, and the Bachelor of Social Work degree.
Chancellor Brown, all candidates for degrees are hereby presented.
Thank you, Provost Starnes. I ask that all faculty present today on the platform and in the audience to stand and remain standing in support of these graduates and as a confirmation of their meeting the rigorous standards set forth by the university. Will all faculty please rise? I now ask all Western Carolina University alumni present today on the platform and in the audience to stand and remain standing as witnesses to the conferral of these degrees and the acceptance of these students into the ranks of loyal alumni. Please rise, everyone. Great. Upon recommendation of the faculty, by the authority invested in me by the University of North Carolina Board of Governors and the Western Carolina University Board of Trustees, and upon completion of all their degree requirements, I confer upon these candidates the degrees for which they have been recommended with all the rights, honors, and responsibilities appertaining thereto. Please join me in congratulating our newest graduates. You may be seated. Graduates, each of you have worked diligently, passionately, and tirelessly, earning the distinct privilege to be seated before us today. You have believed in your dreams. You have set your sights on your goals. You have weathered a once-in-a-century pandemic. You have completed all the difficult and necessary tasks to reach this day, a day that represents one of the most significant milestones in your lifetime, a milestone that makes possible a future of unlimited possibilities. It is your hard work and perseverance that is the main reason that you are here today. The culmination of many hours in researching in the library, hundreds of hours of study and homework, many months in classes and internships, hundreds of hours collaborating with classmates, numerous evenings attending special events on our campus, and the list goes on and on. You hung in there no matter what, no matter how tough it got, working with the tutors and advisors, meeting with professors and staff. You have worked so hard to make us to this day, and you are now here. As citizens of the world, we face many challenges and many opportunities. Excellent healthcare for a changing population, innovation in an age of automation and robotics, development of sustainable, earth-friendly energies, access to affordable and quality education, construction and design of energy-efficient homes and buildings, the creation and performance of art and music,
and the continual discovery of how to maintain the beauty and biodiversity of places like Western North Carolina, while simultaneously supporting a burgeoning hospitality and tourism industry. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. Graduates, it is now up to you to create the world in which you live. It is your freshly born ideas that will create sustainable environments. It is your vision of the future that will eliminate poverty and hunger. It is your ability to take this educational experience and apply it to create international innovation and collaboration. And most importantly, it is your ability to believe in peace, justice, and equality that will make this a reality for all. Graduates, the future is yours, and the world is counting on you. We live in exciting times where employment opportunities offer unique and fulfilling experiences. Many of you have already secured interviews or job offers, have plans to attend graduate school, or have come back to school recently to complete a degree that you may have begun many years ago. As I look out at the passion and energy, the hope and resilience on the faces before me, I must say, we are so proud of you, our Catamounts. Graduates, once upon a time, we stood before you to lead the way. Today, we stand behind you, ready to follow. And we stand beside you, ready to serve as you lead us into the future. Congratulations and go Cats! I now ask that all degree candidates to step forward to receive their diplomas.
Please note that those students graduating summa cum laude, magna cum laude, or cum laude wear the gold cord. Candidates who have served or are currently serving in the United States Armed Forces wear the red, white, and blue cords. Some graduates are wearing cords, stoles, or pins denoting their participation in or affiliation with an organization. Since each individual graduate is recognized by calling their name as they walk across the stage, we ask the entire audience to respect the graduates and their families by refraining from the use of artificial noisemakers, such as air horns. We also ask that you remain seated and stay for the entire ceremony. From the Brinson Honors College, College of Health and Human Sciences, Lauren Ashley Walters. Bowman Thomas Wiseman, summa cum laude. Ashley Rebecca Davis, magna cum laude. Grace Page Barnett, cum laude. Carly Reed Davis, magna cum laude. Alexis Danielle Baldwin, summa cum laude. Hannah Nicole Miller, summa cum laude. Sabrina Elizabeth Harkey, magna cum laude. Sloan Martin Goodman, cum laude. Caitlin Marie Heron, cum laude. Gregory Hunter Pope, magna cum laude. Jessica Faith Duckwall, summa cum laude. Connor John Hines, cum laude. Mackenzie Grace Snyder, cum laude. Brittany Autumn Dillingham, magna cum laude. Jackson Troy Potter, summa cum laude. Natalie Frances Christoff, summa cum laude. Catherine Marie Hill, summa cum laude. Delaney C. Burke, magna cum laude. Katie Michelle Klein, summa cum laude. Serena Anita Shaw, magna cum laude. Connor Ann Henderson, summa cum laude. Sydney Marie Henson, magna cum laude. Thomas Graham Buchanan, magna cum laude. Samantha Piper Garrell, summa cum laude. Celeste Riley Rochelle Dean, summa cum laude. Megan Alexis Moser, summa cum laude. Lindsay Morgan Price, summa cum laude. Isabella Diane Taft, cum laude. Maddox Elizabeth Bolris, summa cum laude. Jonathan Charles Lohr II, summa cum laude. Grayson Lee Haskins, cum laude. From the College of Health and Human Sciences, Cody Ray Odell Baumgartner. Lauren Elizabeth Brown, cum laude. Hannah Kathleen Connolly, summa cum laude. Sierra Blazelin Green, cum laude. Randa K. Romstad. Anna Mae Demore, magna cum laude. Meredith Charles Morrison. Kelsey Brianna Hurry, summa cum laude. Sarah Mims Juergen, summa cum laude. Catherine Morgan Clausen. Chandler E. Jones. Linda Avery Hobson, summa cum laude. Cami Alexa Willingham, magna cum laude. James Ashton Thomas, magna cum laude. Almaria Rose Hendel, magna cum laude. Elias Alexandros Sellis. Trayvon Donzel Simmons. Rachel Shane Cantor. Christina Dolores Malaire. Megan Marie Hill. Alaya Nicole Stahl, summa cum laude. Brianna Nicole Ledford. Alicia Ruth Brown. Carly Shea Looper, magna cum laude. Rachel Louise Surrett, magna cum laude. Elizabeth Grace Essick, magna cum laude. Megan E. Harward. Michaela Faye Cantrell, summa cum laude. Kelsey Brooke Jackson. Elijah Nathaniel Helm. Shelby Ann Whiteside. Haley Chandler Phillips, summa cum laude. Noelle Christine Frost, cum laude. Amanda Michelle Davis, summa cum laude. Yana Patricia Clark, magna cum laude. Sarah Catherine Walker. Jordan Aline LeMasters. Justice Thurman Walls, cum laude. Natalia Antoinette Windell, cum laude. Naja Samaya Davis. Zachary Felix Fernandez, magna cum laude. Gracie Ann Marie Jenkins. Casey Wren Floyd, magna cum laude. Aaliyah Jasmine Fuller. Constance O'Neill Owen, cum laude. Jessica Brooke Epley, cum laude. Madeline Joy Webb. Angel Nicole Thomas, magna cum laude. Matthew R. Wilkinson. Jordan Madison Marshall, cum laude. Cameron Lane Acoth, cum laude. Cayman Jordan Bennett. Robert Kenneth Benton. Destiny Jasmine Nicole Whitsett. Andrew Morgan Lance. Annalise R. Wilkins, summa cum laude. Caitlin Nicole Kropelnicki. Joshua Lewis Feemster. Noah Glenn Lewis, magna cum laude. Olivia Grace Swalm, summa cum laude. Amy Elizabeth Shute, summa cum laude. Dustin Mark Burton, magna cum laude. Samantha Alice Fortain. Joel Robert Poinsett. Savannah Lauren Brooks. Sierra Nicole Slater. Benjamin Clark Miller. Brandon James Cower. David James Norton, magna cum laude. Victoria Grace Gribble, magna cum laude. Haley Alexis Birchfield, magna cum laude. Katie Jalen Zambrano, magna cum laude. Sheng Yang, summa cum laude. Kayla Mackenzie Beaver, magna cum laude. Catherine Aaron Sands, cum laude. Erica Beth Jolly. Jaden Jennifer Kreisel. Courtney Janae Harris. Nicholas Aaron Tippett. Olivia Kathleen Bridges, cum laude. Karen Talanle Pantala Angeles, summa cum laude. Rebecca Ann Pettigrew. Arangelis Michelle Santiago Boria, magna cum laude. Michaela Colleen Cook. Kirsten Faith Elizabeth Sawyer. Savannah Faith Dobbs, magna cum laude. Serena Jankowski. Haley Elizabeth Ramsey. Kaylin Mackenzie Watts. Harley Marie Schrantz, magna cum laude. Malik Saquon McCrimmon. Amanda Danielle Anastasia Noblin. Hannah Elizabeth Hoekstra. Anne Teresa Francis, cum laude. Joshua Lee Griffith. Kyle Glenn Gilliam. Jessica Jean Cano, summa cum laude. Dallas Marlene Romano. Carly Lynn Austin. Alyssa Nicole Robertson. Sydney Lynn Morgan, magna cum laude. Lydia M. Kircher, cum laude. Kelly Rose McNierney, summa cum laude. Mackenzie Lee Warren. Judah Benjamin Woodall. Haley Renee Price. Ariana Isabel Hernandez. Christina Ann Michael. Carson Elaine Branch. Michaela Lynn Dutcher, cum laude. Brandon Glenn Hendricks. Alec Fletcher Worrell. Madison Ina York. Landon Daniel Brown, cum laude. Hannah Danielle Brown. Megan Elizabeth Anderson, magna cum laude. Kristen Taylor Fletcher, magna cum laude. Brianna Leah Listenby, summa cum laude. Hannah Jacqueline Overman. Brandon Heath Goebel. Theodore Lawson Queen Jr. Alexis Elizabeth Connor. Alexa Lindsay Lovelace. Lauren Ashley Jones, cum laude. Hunter Olivia Ann Medford, cum laude. Kendra Ann Hubbard. Caitlin Faith Stevens, summa cum laude. Nicholas Martin Kirschis, cum laude. David Guy Sturm, magna cum laude. Wyatt Franklin Prophet. Alina E. Salazar. Avery Payne, cum laude. Matthew Edgar Welsh. Will Carlisle Jones, magna cum laude. Lauren Taylor Nichols, summa cum laude. Jada Leanne McClure. Anna Campbell Harris, cum laude. Martha Baker Kelly, magna cum laude. Evelyn Yesenia Gasper, magna cum laude. Abigail Lee Raskoski. Adrienne Francis Manictala, cum laude. Ariti Philippidis. Mala Christine Herring. Anastasia Gamboa. Madison Paige Hawley. Valerie Gwynn Cook, cum laude. Emily Leanne Dotson. Julia Rosemary Reardon. Alan Dalton Price. Jihad Ahmed M. Al-Rawaga, summa cum laude. Tiffany Nicole Fansler, magna cum laude. Kayla Elaine Sloan, magna cum laude. Shayna Marie Schuler, cum laude. Sierra Leslie Buchanan, cum laude. Trent Allen Washer. Ashton Taylor Heilman. Haley Elizabeth Bartlett, cum laude. Cassidy Page Chambers, cum laude. Harper L. Gilreath. Erin Marie Willard, cum laude. Austin Scott Huntington, magna cum laude. Ashley Lauren West, summa cum laude. Ashley Nicole Owl, cum laude. Sarah Madeline Boyd, magna cum laude. Alana Rose Gibson, magna cum laude. Hannah Rose Reap, magna cum laude. Olivia Lula Sepalat, summa cum laude. Andy Charlene Irve, magna cum laude. Kimberlyn Ellen Metcalf, cum laude. Jonathan David Wilhelm. Jonathan Alexander Solarzano, cum laude. Jennifer Marion Lee. John Florendo Lomboy, cum laude. Benjamin James Shaw, magna cum laude. Aaron Page Lawson, magna cum laude. Nadine Heather Langsdorf. Caitlin Marie Revis, cum laude. Tierra Nicole Martinez. Amanda Marcia Cressman, cum laude. Maria Lee Chapman. Brianna Lee Kennedy, magna cum laude. Sarah Elizabeth Cruz. Jessica Marie Baker. Destiny Raylin Roberts, cum laude. Yako Alexandria Ivy, cum laude. Eric Reese Manley, summa cum laude. Joshua Zechariah Allen Wise, summa cum laude. Yelena Trejo Resendiz. Kiara Mercedes Bell. Mary Rachel Carter. Fernando Daniel Diaz. Grayson John Lewis Mislow. Rebecca Catherine Ballard, cum laude. Lindsay Stewart Freeman, magna cum laude. Yareli Mariel Castaneda, cum laude. Jalen Kriya Nicole Warren. Catherine Angelica Licea, magna cum laude. Christopher Mitchell Reed.
Chancellor Brown, all candidates for degrees have now been presented.
Okay, please be patient just for a few seconds to let our graduates return to their seats. Thank you. No, no air horns. Dean Granger, the dean of the Honors College, and previous president of SGA, no. No more air horns. No air horns. Chair Kinney. Okay. Now the moment you've been waiting for. Graduates, please rise. Now, move the tassel to the left to signify earning of your undergraduate degree. Congratulations! Congratulations, congratulations. You may now be seated. You are now alumni of Western Carolina University, and now I introduce to you Mr. Neil Andrews, President of the Alumni Association, to greet you as alumni colleagues.
Thank you, Dr. Brown. Graduates, if no one has told you recently, you look really great wearing purple. Good afternoon, Catamount family. My name is Neil Andrews, and I am the WCU Alumni Association President. And it is truly my pleasure to congratulate you on your accomplishments today. And I'm so glad to be able to welcome you into the ranks of Western Carolina University alumni. Kind of like the way that sounds, fellow alumni. I remind you today that you make a very meaningful transition. Up until now, it's been the university's role to fill you with knowledge and to give you the skills necessary to pursue your future. But you leave Cullowhee today with a new role as alumni to represent WCU to your friends, to your family, to your employers, to your colleagues, and to all of those who will come to know you in the years ahead. You have made memories here in the WE that are going to last you for a lifetime. But I encourage you, don't let this be the end of your Catamount story. Today, you received an alumni lapel pin from the Office of Alumni Engagement, and I encourage you to wear that and to wear it proudly. Please stay connected and involved with your university here at Western Carolina. Participate in the alumni events to keep your network strong and make new connections. Take advantage of the services that remain available to you through the Center for Career and Professional Development. Return to Cullowhee to share your experiences with future generations of Catamount graduates. Make WCU a philanthropic priority, as your financial contributions can make the difference in the lives of students who are going to be following your footsteps. And most of all, remain a part of what makes this place so special to us all, the community. The class of 2021 will go down in WCU history as a very special class. One of incredible resolve and resiliency. The strength that you have displayed in the face of adversity during the global pandemic is an inspiration to us all. I look forward to continuing to serve as your Alumni Association President and hearing about all of the wonderful things that you will do. So go out there and prove your purple Catamount alumni. Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Neil. Before we conclude, let me acknowledge some special individuals who are a part of our ceremony this afternoon. First, I salute all members of the graduating class who are veterans, active duty, guard, and reserve members. Western Carolina University takes great pride in being a military-friendly university, and we are proud of you. Would the students please stand so that we may express our appreciation for your service? Next, let me recognize the families of our graduates. Will the parents or guardians of our graduates please stand? Still, continue standing. Will the spouses and children of our graduates please stand? Will the grandparents and other family members of our graduates please stand? Continue standing. And will the special friends of our graduates please stand? While you are standing, it is my pleasure to invite our graduates to rise and show their appreciation to you for your love, support, and commitment to their future. Thank you. You may be seated. A ceremony like this does not just happen. Please join me in thanking the army of staff colleagues from every part of campus who had a part in making this ceremony a very special occasion for all of us. Let's give them a round of applause. At the conclusion of this ceremony, we ask that the audience exit the Ramsey Regional Activity Center as quickly as possible. Thanks to all of you who have joined us today to share this momentous occasion in the life of our university. Now rise as we sing the alma mater led by Ms. Shropshire and remain standing for the recessional. Following the recessional, this ceremony will be concluded. And again, graduates, congratulations and go Cats!
True, every soul and every Thank you.